There we go. That seems to have gotten the volume issues under control. So, hello! I am EPM, the creator of the Vinception level for the Vinesauce level design contest in SMBX. Given how confusing this level was... when's Corruption's Vinny? Yeah. So, this little area has... like, obviously it's a fake-out, because if you've seen the normal level, there's warps right after this door, but... anyway, up here... the reason this goes here... now, I'm not very good at this, but I figure that since I'm not good at this, that puts me on, like, comparable to just, like, someone who's picking this up. But I've got a controller, I've got to get myself a GameCube controller, and anyway... the idea here was, A, it's funny to make it look out like, oh, this is just a gag level, and then you put the key in the door, and this happens. But there's more to it than that, because that teaches you, like, okay, key, door. That's for someone who's, like, just picking up SMBX. Now, you spawn with the key down there, fully visible, and I don't find this background terribly bothersome, because it's dark. I mean, it's not... it's just... I've ran a bunch of Photoshop filters through most of the graphics. And this background... oh god, there's so much to talk about. Okay, Joel in the background, like, that's all a bunch of Joel. Like, there, you can even see there's Joel's face up there. This is all Joel stuff. And this little bit right here is, yeah, that's a boo, but it's... the thing in front of... the thing that goes in front of Mario, like, right here, that I'm jumping through right now, that's the boo sprite, right above Fanto. And it's set to friendly, so it can't hurt you. So, despite being distinctive and chasing you around, it can't hurt you. But, like, this background is literally just Joel giggles layered with, like, mashed up with Mussorgsky's, the fun on hut on Fowl's legs. I've dubbed it the house out Joel's ass after his comment after Vinny called Dio Goku. Anyway, the first sign is just, beware, when riding the Mega Mugmobile, your hitbox becomes as large as the vehicle's. Okay. Also, the Mega Mugmobile is a closet juggalo, but feels very comfortable around Mario. Now, just for the sake of weirdness, I put the Mega Mugmobile in this... like, normally it would spawn down there on that yellow thing, but it's in this egg. And when Vinny missed the egg, I shat a brick, because the idea was, oh crap, he just missed something very important to the level. And the reason why it says closet juggalo is that while I changed the graphics for it, and they'll... they work, it's just that when you get in it, it stops working, which is so weird. I couldn't find the actual graphic data for the cart, which is so strange. It's apparently just not... it's not available to mess with in SMBX. So you go with this thing, it's like, what the fuck is this? Because obviously this is a very strange level. And like, if you go forward with it, you'll hit that, so... chat, stop parroting everything. And like the message said, your hitbox is as large as the vehicle, so... the signs get very annoying because of that, but up here is... okay, there's this. Jeez, where do I start? Okay, we'll just start with this area. There's this area over here, which you could kind of mess with, and I didn't realize it, but you could cheat it if you... like, I realized this later in development, but you can get under here and then just jump out of the thing and mess around with it under there, so you can skip the bombs if you want. But that's not terribly... helpful. Up here is the ugliest water section I have ever seen, let alone made. These are all different water graphics, and despite the graphics being incredibly weird, like, the coral here is supposed to give it and the water bubbles that are normal. It's like, yeah, okay, this is water, and as you can see, yeah, water. And that's consistent over there. So let's go over here. Like, oh look! All the... a lot of the level design like, this is just avatars for people who posted in the level design contest. And this is just me glad I used the Smash Mouth Eggs All-Star Loop. That's the, so much to do, so much to see, that was used in the Fantastic game. So, some one-ups. Now, there's a reason for this tree and those... like, there's a lot of... there's a method behind the madness, even though it doesn't look like it. Which is... admittedly my fault. Because... like, these squares, like, you can jump on... you can't jump on this one, but see how Joel's... like... oh no, you're not gonna see that. But... Joel's right there, the Jorgle thing that was from one of the pieces of fan art, was... like, there's a green outline around it, so I made it look more solid that way. God, I love this. The, song that is. Yeah, there's the spooky thing. I was really mad that I didn't see the chat's reaction to this level, because I just fell asleep. I was working hard throughout the summer, and just, it was the end of the week, I was just like, oh, I can't take it anymore. So, this boo does damage to you if you make contact with it, but... it's this is staple to it, and you need to hit that yellow switch. Like, you don't need to, but it's very useful. That's one of the, like, optional objectives, because this level is non-linear. You might... oh, God. Yeah, that's very annoying. And then there's this little Vinny ship that was missed that shoots Rinkas. And, oh, yeah. It is so annoying that... yeah, that's why I put a warning to the player, because that genuinely is very annoying. And you may have caught on that there's no real midpoint to this level. That's because when you know what you're doing, that serves itself as a shortcut. Like, just knowing where to go in this just intentionally chaotic mess serves as a shortcut. And that was by design. The idea being, yeah, I don't need a midpoint. Like, I shouldn't need a midpoint, because the idea is, once you learn the route, that is in and of itself a shortcut. Love little distortion. Honestly, that's one of the things I hate, and definitely a flaw in the level, is that this goddamn ship. Like, yeah, it's a closet juggalo because it turns into the clown car whenever Mario's in contact with it. So these things, like, God, there was originally a intro section, like before, like between the outside warp and then this inner area, that taught the use of these, like, these other blocks, but I cut it out because it just felt clunky to use. And that is the Anger Impact Big Boo. And I chose to mess with the Big Boo face, like, that was the first thing I changed, just because, like, coming from Raukow's videos, it's just, the idea of not changing the Big Boo sprite is almost just alien to me. Come on. Ah, right. The okay thing is actually a resprited ship from, like, I left the jet trail alone, and, like, the movement should give away, like, yeah, okay, this is an airship thing, because if you go over here, this lets you go through here. But, because, whoa, yeah, it becomes a moving platform, though, but, anyway, over here are the good power-ups, like, this is just, like, the room of good power-ups. There's a reason for this, because... what this level really wants to do, like, what I really wanted the... I'm a dim ass. Yeah, as I said before, not so good at this, but... There we go. The reason I made this level the way I did, like, the idea is that it's a non-linear exploration level. I wanted to do something, like, super Metroid-y. And sure, it has a very, very, very weird graphic style, but... but even in light of that, it's consistent, like... graphic A is graphic A no matter what you do to it. So, like, these doors are all over the frigging place. And, yeah, this thing right here down there is the face from the Mega Man sprite game. And, so, yeah, you can see there's, like, there's a power-up in there, so I'll leave it alone for now. But there's also, if you go through it, a way into here. Because you're able to pass through those blocks and that one. But, here, come on, let's get back there, because... these doors are designed to eventually take you back to where you originally went to go, or at least near that. And yeah, okay. Or at the very least to an area that's, you know what, fine, let's roll with this. I'll just go play this as I would, like, well, not just... see, this is a bit of looter magic, that the more well-known Mario Maker. Here, can I get up to... there we go. That's... get back up through... oh dear. You are gonna be a pain in... this is gonna be a pain in the ass. You know what? On second thought, down we go. Let's dig. Yeah, this is, like, actually part of the point, was that, like, if the player got frustrated doing something, they could just wander off and do it another way. Because the level has very few objectives, like, hard objectives, and hopefully you'll see them if I'm not a complete idiot. But yeah, here we go. Back here. You can walk through boxes, because these are Super Mario Bros. 3 boxes. Yeah, here we go, we're back here. So, back here, there's an Easter egg right here that I fully didn't intend, like, I knew nobody would find this, but over here with Hitler, like, right, well, the toad here kind of gives it away. It's like, your mustache is better, Mario! Infernal shriek, and he does make an infernal shriek. So, what happens if you go up into Hitler's mustache, you caught Nigel Thornberry's nose! And yeah, despite, like I said before, the level's consistent, despite it being weird. Like, these are all the same water graphics, absolutely hideous though they are, as was around the Vine Shrine, we'll call that little bit of the level. And part of the level's weirdness is intended that to be, like, landmarks, because, let's face it, giant Nigel Thornberry, and whatever the hell this is, and Dudley Do-Right with green hair, and a dual disc codpiece, those are distinctive, they're memorable. So, even though it's difficult to navigate the level, I mean, you can navigate it quickly, but you can't navigate it accurately, and that's intentional. But even with that in mind, it's still, like, there's landmarks. It's easy to identify, oh, I'm here again. So, go into this door, and we're back here by the Alpine region. And over here, as you can see, the green switch, or green switch, yellow switch that the Boo guards leads to this door. So, where does that go? Well, it's pretty accessible from over here, because that Boo is facing the other way. So if you sneak up on him, which is the idea here... Oh, nope, he caught me once he wasn't facing me. And the thing is, you gotta hit it quick, otherwise he'll box you in. Get out of here, get out of here! Ah, crap! Yeah, that's a trap here, so now I have to go through the other door. But that brings me to the other Boo boss, which is over here, but he provides this. So if you've already gotten the suit, you can do that, and it's attached to that Boo, so now it stops following around, but you're stuck here again. Over here. Like, yeah. It's funny, because in Vinny's play, he came right over here. This is right where he commented on the background track, I think. And I was crestfallen, because he was so close to finding this. Like, here, let's get over here. Let me do a little bit of digging. I'm an idiot. Okay. There's, hey, Rinka, go away. Oh, yeah, there's that Rinka generator right down there. Making this a little less easy, because there's something to this area, you may expect. Okay, get away from me. Admittedly, ah, come on, that caught me. I mean, the hitboxes aren't modified. Just gotta take care of this little challenge with the Rinkas. That's the idea, was many challenges going through this. It's like, going into this, my idea was, I don't have ideas for one level. I have lots of ideas, so I'm just gonna mash them up into mini levels, and you can complete whatever number of mini levels you want, because, well, non-linear overall. So let's go down. God damn it! Alright, yeah, that's just me being incompetent, but, oh well. See, this will highlight the lack of midpoints pretty well. Because, yeah, you start over here, but, and the reason, oh yeah, by the way, these blocks right here, those are so that if you accidentally just let go of the key, it doesn't go off screen and you're just screwed, and you'd have to kill yourself by falling down there. That's just a prevention for that. So, now you spawn near the Mega Mugmobile, so come on, you just go up this way, and let's get ourselves back to the... See, this is the ghost ship is right above ourselves. Let's call it that, the ghost ship. That's like a mini boss of sorts, is this ghost ship. And just to be, now, a weird quirk of the SMBX engine, I could do this here with the shell, but that, huh? Because the thing is that Koopa, if you jump on him or kill him, it plays the "you died" sound effect, the sound, and it does that. Wonder if I can... that was only... Yeah, that didn't hit it. I mean, it hit it once, but it didn't... It hit it... Turn it back off, so... Okay. Got a commando mission. This by not turning around. Show no fear! Because then the Boo gets you! Yeah, managing that Boo is, like, supposed to be a mini-boss of sorts. But it's not necessary to do that. Because you can find other ways of getting through this area. So, okay, let's say, screw that Boo. I don't want to do that. Let's do something else. Well, okay. You can see from this area that this goes down, and there's another reason for that. That's to be just an area. Like Vinny said, like, he wanted to see what the point of this was, but he didn't have the time. So this right here, if you take the face ship down here, because this is the thing, that's why I put it in the egg, was that way you can take it with you. Even through the doors, you can take it with you. Which unfortunately is something just Vinny didn't get, which I probably should have put a sign. But then I figured, like, I have two signs already, it's getting wordy, and as you saw from other levels, text-heavy levels gets, like, you want to show, not tell. So, alright, let's leave the Mega Mug Mobile here. Down here, the Chozo with the note block is just amusing. Here. That is a shy guy, because if he turned the other way around, you'd see... Oh, no, 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 you don't. Yep, there he is, there's shy guy. Go over there. Off he goes. And yeah, this is just... I put the signs in as just commentary for myself. NPCs are different, like the Toad. I might as well have named this level Complete Abuse of Photoshop Filters, because that's how I did most of these screwy graphics, like the warped Shy Guy, for example. But yeah, then if you come over here, this vaguely Metroid-y shaped wad of blocks was originally going to be set as an individual layer and stapled onto an invisible edited boost sprite, much like the cluster of noise that you spawn near. So let's get away from the Renka, and down here... yeah. Hey, Luigi. I'm not here! And he's not. Ourselves through the door, and we're back over at the face ship. Let's see if I can. No, it's so weird, because... There it goes! Yeah, it gets attached to the shell, not the Koopa. Yes, yeah, that's great. That's not a delayed timer after you talk to Luigi. It just says, yes, Chad, it was all in his head. And I don't know why it does that. Oh, right, because I said it to. Well, I mean, I don't remember why I told it to do that, is what I mean. Like, item get sound. Okay, let's go over here. No, wait, I have an idea. Now, there's a reason for this section with the bone ship. The boner boat, as Vinny dubbed it. Because you can see there's the almighty loaf right there. The idea is this is a repeatable source of the vine. Because, see, you grew back over there. And while there's other sources of vines throughout the level... Like, let's get over... I know, let's get over here. Come on! Up the shrine. The reason this is here is because... Now, you get hints of this, like, especially if you fly upward. If you fly up, you'll eventually find this. And there's also warps that will take you this way. Like, see, there's the platform. This is one of the level's end goals. That leads to the key. That door leads to the key, and you can see I made it look very important. And one of the ways of getting to the red switch is by beating the big boo and going through that door, which will eventually take you to a cycle, so on and so forth. But let's just keep exploring around, because, again, non-linear level. Go away! Oh yeah, there's the Vinny ship. Vinny himself killed me, how karmic. Okay, you know what? What's the... Don't hurt me. Yeah, that's... I feel bad about cheating on my own level, but... Yeah, it's built to have a decent challenge to it, but much like Vinny, the point here is just to show it off. Actually, no, you know what? No cheating. Just because I shouldn't. I really shouldn't. I will take my lumps. I'll look like a fool if I have to. Because I designed this level, goddammit. And sure, it's like, even while playtesting this, like, ugh, that is the one thing I hate most, is that the goddamn ship turns into, like, it triggers NPC messages. That annoys me so much. Die! Kill the Rex. Hey, get over here. And here's an obscure thing, you can kill enemies with the egg. Well, you can hurt them, rather. I mean, if they're three hitters like the Big Boo, that's not gonna work. But yeah, the level gives you a lot of vines in various places, actually. Okay, I can actually use them to kill Big Boo right there. It's actually a cheap trick for a lot of the bosses, is holding an item that you uproot will just stay in your hands even though it's dealing lots of damage to them. So, okay, here, let's get the... to do the hammer suit. So yeah, this is the thing, is that you can carry this, you can carry these vines, and even the face ship of the Mega Mug Mobile, as I dubbed it, throughout the doors, to, like, basically sequence break the level at your discretion if you want to. that mechanic, sadly, was just missed. Vinny didn't get it. Even though the level has really weird graphics, it's not a joke level. Look there, beat that. And oh hey, if I get to the green switch, I get that. And that is a very powerful item to carry around. Like, those are all vine oh, good lord, Vinny, what just happened to you? I guess the sprite respawned. Come up here. And you're below here, so oh god, get away from me! What goes down, you're back over here. Unless you fell over there, which is entirely possible to happen. So over here, let's get through the Vine Shrine's door right over there. It doesn't take you to a very important place, but it does get you close. Down here, you could just jump over here, get over here, but there's nowhere we could really go from here. And I believe there's a warp down there, but I don't remember. Like, just a random Easter egg warp. But that's not intended to be just found unless, like, it's just a tongue-in-cheek, like, yeah, wow, you're really smart if you fell down there. But yeah, you can see the levels changed, because now... the thwomp. I got myself with that thwomp trap. Come here. Oh, yeah. If you hit the block, it tells you about this little secret, semi-secret, with the vine trap. Oh, but it got away. So let's go through the Hitler door. And back on the ice land, and as you see, this brings you closer to that to motivate you. Okay, kill that ghost, and you'll be able to go through there. Oh, I game overed. How shameful! Shameful to display. I mean, there's very little penalty for that, considering no midpoint, so on and so forth. Very non-linear level. So I'm pretty much right back where I wanted to be. And let's see if I can't. Yeah, you're not able to do that, but you can see there's something down there. There we go. Alright, so through the little playground once again. Let's grab our vine ship and find ourselves a door. Let's go down here. Whee! There's a trap here because... eh, not much of a trap, but it takes you over here. You could go... okay, avoid the Rinka. There we go. Down there. Yeah, okay, we're back here. Die, Koopa. Die, EPM. So, yeah, you can see I'm not good at this. I'm not competent, but I can beat my own level. The thing is just, it's difficult to be A, competent, and like, just like, I could just go through this as quickly as I could, but that conflicts with my desire to actually show it off entirely. And if I'm just beating it as fast as I can, that doesn't really happen, but sure, fine, let's... see, try to remember the route. It's not really a quick route. I mean, there's certainly multiple ways of doing things, but here, let's... oh, crap! Yeah, that's safety... oh, the Rinkas! Yeah, the Rinka hitbox is a little weird. And that's not my doing. That's just in the base game itself. Because it's tied to the block, and it's a round object. So, fine, let's just go the way Vinny went, down here. He's in the Hitler room, but let's get out of the Hitler box, back down here, back to the face ship. Go away, Rinka! The Rinkas. Oh, they're pushing the face ship! Let's just get it out of the way, because there's a bit of a secret, not a secret, but you can get out of the face ship and go through here, because this is one of the things that are just background globs. And you'd be able to notice that from just the initial mesh of just chaos, the just corruption glob that you find near the start. This is in it, and it'll pass right through you, so that's the only clue that you can go through that. It's not much of one, but it's there. Can I go through this? Yes, I can. Okay, so let's go up here, because go through there. It'll take you back down here. Let's just cycle through this for a while, because you can. Alright, here, we can grab this block, which gives huge jumps, and get away from the Volcano Lotus. Go through here. Yeah, that's the door that leads nowhere. Though it does make you drop your item, which is a little amusing. Oh, I thought I caught that. Okay, there were 50 warps in this level, but fine, I'll just change it for this item. There are 50... okay, so I'm less bothered by that now. Because if I go here and place this down... ah, crap. Oh no, the plan is to... oh, whatever. There's a lot of ways of doing things, because if I brought a vine over here, I'd be able to get it. And, hi, that's a squid. Okay, let's see. What am I gonna do? See, this is how deliberately messy I made the level. Even I, the level's creator, can't fully recall the full route through here. But yeah, let's just get around for a while. Like, if you just mash up, you'll eventually get somewhere. Just somewhere. So let's go over here. Yeah, okay, that's one area. Like, you can see there's little mini loops, but I want to go up there. Grab that, go through there, back here, go through here, back here, there we go. Now I'm in a place where, okay, there we go. And died off, there it go, there it went, it hit lava. And just plays the sound of Mario dying just as an extra level of, wah! So. Oh, for crying out loud, really? Get down from there! Oh, you stupid. Whatever, I guess that was my fault, but, I mean, I'm willing to make that mistake. It's a mistake. It's my mistake. It wasn't the level being just badly made, and believe me, I'm the maker of the level. I'd be the one most upset if it was badly made. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Grab another one. Just spam the doors, and we're back. So you see, it's not impossible to get where you want to go once you learn, like, the layout of things. Admittedly, this is not the kind of level I should have submitted to the level contest. Like, there we go. God damn it. Okay, go over. Ah! There we go. And it leads me back down there. Yeah. Screw you! Oh yeah, there we go. We're back here. So either of those doors eventually leads you up here. And if you go down here, what happens if you go in here? You're back over here. So go to the center, and you unlock the green switch. And it deliberately prevents itself from being hit again, because it's fairly important. Get through there. Yeah. Lets you go over the die swooper. Let's... There we go. Got rid of those two. And now I get the vine ship. The Vinny mobile. No. Up the Rika. Nope. The Rika. God, this thing's protected. There we go. Ah! There we go. There we go. I've got protection now. I have myself a weapon. I can get to wherever I want to go. And let's see, there's the red boo over here. Okay, come here, boo. There it goes. It's down there. Ah, oh, it's in a now the lava's in a position, I'll have to warp to it. And if you go down there, I think you saw earlier, it just leads you back up here with vines if you need to. But okay, so that's... There we go, got rid of the boo. Killed the boo, that's one of the ways of killing the boo. And yeah, once you get this thing, it's much easier to go around the level. Whoops. Much easier to get around the level, because you can just murder anything that stands in your way. So yeah, let's get ourselves back up. So I can just platform back up with... Okay. And it's deliberately, like, the background Joel will literally say, this is fucking stupid. Just by hit on his own, whatever the, music lowers from its initial volume. Okay, let's see. Did I get this right? Yeah, there we go. Okay, we killed the boo, so now we can hit this just fine. What the heck? Oh, the block itself killed me because it got dropped and then crushed me. Oh, that's collision detection killed me there. I am not happy about that. Because I was used to doing that without the thing right there. So here, fine. Let's do this to kill the ghost. Alright, fine. Let's not do that to kill the ghost. Because there's other options. There's... Grab the Vinny ship. Egg. Rather, no, that's not a Vinny ship egg. That's a... one of those okay airship block things. Like, that'll... go over here. Yeah, that'll lead eventually over here. And up there is the, door that leads to the exit, so this is deliberately... Show no fear to the ghost, show no fear to the ghost. Die! Okay. Ghost is dead, I could... So there's multiple ways of doing that, but here, let's just mash up until... Let's say, frustrated player, let's get around. Oh yeah, this is a place to get one of the items, because you'll need it to get up there, but that is one of the ways to go. So, yeah. That will eventually cycle you someplace important. There we go. Be careful not to fall in the lava. There we go. Okay, Okay, ghost is dead. Let's hit that yellow switch. There we go. And I put that on the side just as A, that means like get out quick, because it'll crush you if the ghost is still alive after you've hit that. And also, just as an indication of, yeah, you've hit the blocks, because, like, if you spin jump or jump multiple times, it could be a little dicey to tell, like, okay, did I really hit it or not? So let's go through the door we've unlocked. It leads over here, which is where another door would drop you eventually. That leads you to the Vine Shrine. Follow the Vine Shrine doors enough. As before, you get back here. So let's get ourselves. The Gear Fingers Dreadful Pig from that one fan art of bootleg streamers to go with Vinny. If you talk to Peach, adventure! Oops. Ah, whatever. That should get me where I... That won't get me where I want to go, but it does let me do this. Let's go over here. Woohoo! What's going on? Oh, God! It'll eventually spit you out on its own. Like, it's... The warps in there are... They'll deliberately just drop you out of it if you're not holding any direction eventually. Okay, I think I messed it up on this, but on the other hand, lets me get a running start. No. Aw, crap. I screwed myself! Because I can't get out now! Crap, let's see if I can. That's a problem. Never caught that during testing, but can I get up there? Aw, crap. I am very unhappy to find that. Can this kill me? Okay, let's see. Okay, that's annoying here. Let's. Okay, that is a pain in the ass. I did not realize that would happen. Man, that is like I would have taken point. That would have been a point off just for that right there. If I was doing, if I was grading this level, that'd just be a point off just then and there. I like how Vinny broke into the crawling song when he found the Goomba. Because really, Goombas are... They live a sad life. Like, imagine you're born a Goomba in the Mario universe. You are just doomed. You are fragile, you are useless, you are helpless. It is a sad, sad existence to be a Goomba. Go away. Okay, let's grab ourselves a vine from down here again. Oh! That's the thing about the face ship that bothers me. Like, the hitbox on the face ship bugs me so much. Because it'll cut, crush, and kill some enemies, but it'll get hurt by others. Fine, let's just grab our vine ship and go down there. Get over here. There we go, back over here. Now, there's 50 warps and 50 doors. Even I can't remember the full way through this level. So let's just... For God's sake, the one area it couldn't be... I am doing terribly with these goddamn... Thankfully, that spits you out somewhere fairly important, so it'll at least get you to... fine, let's get ourselves a vine. Go away. Just up, up. Just spam up. Just literally spamming up or just going wherever will eventually get you someplace useful. Like so. It's programmed that, like, if the... It's designed so that, like, if the player gets frustrated, it'll be easier. So yeah, there we go. It's originally an earlier section with this earlier that would have demonstrated that was transparent, but anyway, you go through here, and goddammit, you're back down here. So, all that for nothing? Well, not exactly. It's just that that is supposed to point you to just keep struggling with this. You just be persistent. And okay, let's see if I can't. Yeah, let's just hold this platform for a while. Oh wait, that's the door I can keep it through. Okay. So where do I want to go right now? Let's see. I don't think I've tried this door. Oh, that's the... I did. That's the door that you... Wait, I know where to go. Well, I don't know, but I do have an inkling. And there it goes. It worked properly that time. Okay, grab ourselves the lava boot that the boo guards... Yeah, I remember. Grab the lava boot. Go through this door. Can I carry things? No, I can't carry things. Okay, so... There's a secret, as I said before, exit down there. Well, not an exit, but it'll get you straight to the red switch that's in the lava. There's a 1-up. Yep. And there's a ninji. Corrupted ninji. Here, let's just get out of our boot. Oh, get away from there. The hitbox on those bombs is... I guess you can see it's circular, so it's... Oh, the boot is keeping it from respawning, I believe. Yeah, there it goes. Okay, there we go. Get more room on that. Oh, I've made myself a pain in the ass to get out of. Okay, wait, let's see. Ah! Ah, oh, whatever, that makes it easier to escape. These Rinkas! So deliberately annoying. Yeah, like, I can play this level and not get bored of it, even though I'm the one who made it and playtested it. I'm not bored. I'm having fun playing this level. So that's just, like, I'm happy with that. I created a level I can enjoy, and that was something just I considered very, very important. But here, let's just do this the easy way. There. Much better. Not much better. There we go. So if I were not being an idiot, I could just... No, no, not this time. Not this time. I'm not falling for that three times. So yeah, you go through there, and there's nothing. But there's a door! And it takes you to the red switch. There's multiple warps that lead there. Like, the doors will eventually get you there, even if you're just mashing through them. There's a secret door back here, hidden within sand. So that's once again reiterating the idea of knowing your way around. Like, familiarity with the level is itself a midpoint of sorts. Now this looks like, oh crap, can't get out. Well, yes you can. It takes you back here, which eventually leads you back to the Vine Shrine. And there's a reason it takes you back here. Because, see this tree? If you're flying around with the Vine Ship... Here, let's just grab these 1-ups. Hey, get back here. Okay, here, fine. Let's just go down here. All right, the Vine Ship's gone. Here, let's grab a vine from down here. Get back here, you asshole! Oh, for God's sake, not my phone. It's my morning alarm, or rather, afternoon alarm. Morning alarm, just used to that being the relevant one. Go away, Big Boo. Shouldn't be so laissez-faire with those. How do I scroll the screen? Oh, whatever. Big Boo, you are so annoying. Let's see here. There we go. There we go. Much better. Okay. Got self teddy bear suit. I can't call it teddy bear suit. I'm so used to Rao Cow. Okay. Grab ourselves a vine. There's plenty of these all through the level. That's supposed to be a hint of sorts is why there's so many of them. But even if you... Screw you, Swooper. Let's just get back. Yeah, that's even more. And those don't respawn, but there are respawning ones, like was visible. Yeah, like, see, if you see through there, that's where you need to go with the thing. And the tree right here is the hint. That's where to put it. Now, even if the Boo is alive and on screen, if you just approach the vine from that direction, he won't bother you. So yeah, there we go. That leads up here. I'm back to his spawn radius. That's weird. There we go. Finally got the key. Yeah, we're back here. Because that leads back down here. And there's an escape route of sorts. Because if you go down here, go here, go here, go here. Back through here. Back through here. There we go. No, no, no! Come back here! son of a bitch. Oh yeah, you can't get hit by the sides of these spikes in this game, which is very nice. Okay. There we go. And no, I'm not, Vinny. You're very correct. Though, if you go here... Let's see, if I recall correctly, there's... Did I take that out, or did I leave that in? Yeah, I think I took... Yeah, originally the sign was over here, I think. And yeah, you can't fall down there, because that just continues through here. Teacup! And that was the level. So, that was as I intended, as far as the level design contest went.